going on? This is Don from Carpet Peel Pros. I wanted to do a real quick video just to kind of show you this air manifold setup that we did and kind of how it works, the pieces you need if you want to build one. If you need help, you can always give us a call. We're happy to help. But anyways, I kind of just wanted to review it for you. So if you can imagine here, this is where your air line is going to be coming in at. So you have your air compressor over here on your left side. You have your air line coming in here. So this is our half inch Tosami water separator. Basically, it gets all the water out of your airlines that we can run your equipment without getting, you know, water and things like that caught in the line. So this is a half inch thread right here. So you can quick connect it on with your air hose, or you can just manually thread it in. And then down here at the bottom, you can put like a nipple if you want, or like a hose barb, and then you can run, you know, hose just to drip it on the floor. If not, it'll just shoot out the bottom. It's not really a big deal. Anyways, they're kind of expensive, but they are the best in the industry. Really quality product, really heavy. You can get smaller ones depending on what size airline and what size CFM you're running. So this one here is obviously for a bigger one. We run 30 CFM on our system. But you can do it smaller, it doesn't really matter. Anyways, and then right here we just have our pressure regulator. So you want to have your water separator first so it can separate the water, and then you can regulate your pressure. This will blow, it's rated up to like 250 PSI, and you shouldn't be running anything more than that. We certainly don't run anything less than 100 PSI, so it's not an issue. So you want to have this first, then you have here for your pressure regulator, and then you want to get a good, you can see the bubble in there, you want to get a good water-filled gauge. Don't get one of the cheap ones at Harbor Freight. Spend the, you know, a little bit of money. They're not that much. Get a water-filled gauge. So anyways, this way you can just kind of pull it here, adjust your pressure. Sorry, it's hard to do this with one hand. Push it in, and you're good to go. And then on here, we just put a shutoff. And we got these shutoffs, and basically you can do on or off. So if we turn this off, it'll stop air from going anywhere else to the system. Just like an override if something happens. So all that is we just have a little ball valve here, and then this nipple, I want to say it's like a 1 or a 2 inch nipple. Let me get this out of the way. And then here, I think it's another 2 inch nipple. Goes into a half inch three way. Another, I don't know, 2 or 3 inch nipple. And then it goes into the valve itself. So all of these, you know, open and close. We literally duplicated the exact same thing here. And then we did it again here, except on this end, you can kind of see, we put a plug on it, you know, just to kind of stop it. You could probably do a 90 on this last piece if you wanted. We just did this if we needed to add on. So we run two air setups, two 1-inch air pumps. And then also if you want to fill up tires or anything like that. So this is our main shutoff to our manifold. This right here would be for, just say, our rinsing 1-inch pump. This would be for our chem pump. And then this would be for if you wanted to fill up, you know, air up tires or do whatever, you know, blow something out of your truck. And then we'll just reduce it down to whatever fittings that we need to hook up our pumps and things like that. So that's kind of a setup. Black pipe is rated for air, so it's fine. If you want to spend the money, you can do it in copper. It's just double the price. We built this whole thing pretty inexpensively and got all the parts local. So you shouldn't have a problem finding it. And the copper, you may have to go to like a specialized store, or you can go to Amazon and order, you know, some of the three ways, the T's, made out of copper. But again, it's not really, you don't have to do it. Our last one, we did copper and it was just really expensive, and it really didn't seem to do any better of a job than what the black pipe did. It just looks a little bit prettier, But anyways, so it's just a quick video of an air manifold setup for a roof cleaning rig. You could use it for pressure washing too, you know, if you're running anything that needs air. Anyways, if you have questions, please make sure you leave them down below or send us a private message. We'll be happy to help you with your manifolds. Thanks.